First lesson from that, A Hero. A Hero is written by R.K. Narayan, one of the famous writer. First, we'll see about the author. R.K. Narayan is widely considered to be one of the greatest Indian English novelist, who is known for his simple, unpretentious writing style. He is best known for his works set in the fictional South Indian town of Malabi. His books include Swami and His Friends, Bachelor of Arts, The English Teacher, and The Financial Expert. His novel, The Guide, was adopted for the film and it won the Sahitya Academy Award. He highlights social content and provides a feel for his character through everyday life. He was nominated to Rajya Sabha, the upper house of India's parliament. So this is about R.K. Narayan. He is widely considered to be one of the greatest Indian English novelist of our country. He is known for his simple and plain. Those who read and want to know about his work, no, it's very easy and it is very simple. Anyone can understand the stories. He is best known for his books set in the fictional South Indian town of Malabar. So one of the imagination of R.K. Narayan was Malabar. I think you have seen that serial in the Kannada, Malgudi Days. So that Malgudi Days is his imagination. His book includes Swami and His Friends. This everything is goes in that Malgudi village. And another greatest work of Narayan is The Bachelor of Arts, The English Teacher and Financial Expert. So these are his famous books. And one of his novel, The Guide, was adopted for film. And also it is adopted for the film and this film won Sahitya Academy Award. He highlighted social content and provides a feel for character through everyday life. Whatever the things that going on in the daily life, no? Based on that he had written in his stories. He was nominated to Rajya Sabha, the upper house of India's parliament. And even he became a member of Rajya Sabha, the upper house. Now we'll see what is there in the lesson, A Hero. So this lesson, A Hero, here, this goes on through the courage and strength. Those who have strength and courage, they can do anything. So that is the main theme of this lesson. We'll see how Swami showed his courage, whether he showed or not, whether he showed his strength, we'll see in this lesson. A Hero, R.K. Narayan. First, Swami even took an unexpected turn. Father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, "Swami, listen to this. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad who, while returning home by the jungle path, came face to face with a tiger." Dear children, if you are having your textbook, you can go through that while I am reading. The paragraph described the fight the boy had with the tiger and his flight up the tree where he stayed off a day till some people come that way and killed the tiger. After reading it through, father looked at Swami fixedly and asked, "What do you say to that?" Swami said, "I think he must have been a very strong and grown-up person, not a boy at all. How could a boy fight a tiger?" "You think you're wiser than the newspaper?" father sneered. "A man may have the strength of an elephant and it to be a coward, whereas another may have the strength of a straw. But if he has courage, he can do anything. Courage is everything. Strength and age are not important." Swami disputed the theory. "How can it be, father? Suppose I have all the courage, what could I do if a tiger should attack me?" "Leave alone strength. Can you prove you have courage? Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office room." A frightful proposition, Swami thought. He had always slept beside his granny in the passage, and any change in this arrangement kept him trembling and awake all night. He hoped at first that father was only joking. He mumbled weakly, "Yes," and tried to change the subject. He said very loudly and with a great deal of enthusiasm, "We are going to admit even elders in our cricket club hereafter. We are buying brand new bats and balls. Our captain has asked me to tell you." "We will see about that later," father cut in. "You must leave alone hereafter." Swami realized that the matter had gone beyond his control. For a challenge, it had become a command. He knew his father's tenacity at such moments. For the first of next month, I will sleep alone, father. No, you must do it now. It is disgraceful sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby. You are in the second form and I don't like the way you are being brought up. He said and looked at his wife, who was rocking the cradle. Why do you look at me while you say it? She asked. I hardly know anything about the boy. No, no, I don't mean you, said father. If you mean your mother is spoiling him, tell her so and don't look at me, she said and turned away. So we'll see the expression of this now, children. So your Swami's father, he had a habit of reading newspaper. Daily used to read the newspaper. He was reading the newspaper. We'll see what happened. Swami always, he will be in trouble because of his talk, because of his behavior. We'll see how he get into the trouble here. First, Swami events took an unexpected turn. So here is one of the event which took unexpected turn in the life of Swami. We'll see what was that incident. Father looked over the newspaper he was reading under the hall lamp and said, he was reading the newspaper and he read some news in that. Swami, listen to this, and he is explaining what is there in the newspaper to his son. Swami, listen to this. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad. Lad means it's an old English. It means boy. News has been received about the bravery of a village lad who were returning home by the jungle path. Jungle means forest. So while he was returning from the jungle path, he took his cows or something to the jungle itself, and he was returning from the jungle path. That boy came to face with the tiger. So this was the incident that reported in the newspaper. So this report Swami's father told to his son. The paragraph described the flight the boy had with the tiger. So here it briefly explains that how that boy that fight with the tiger, that boy who was returning home by the jungle path, that boy and his flight of the tree, and he suddenly he fought with the tiger, and after sometimes he flight up the tree because he wanted to escape from the tiger. No, so he flight up the tree where he stayed half a day. That village boy, he stayed half a day on the tree itself. So while he sat there, so he wanted some people come that way and kill the tiger. So he thought some people will come that way and they'll kill the tiger so that he can escape from that. After reading it through, father looked at Swami fixedly and asked, what do you say to that? So if our father, if he asked us, no, we would have reacted that, oh, what a strong boy is, he had done like that. Like that we would respond to our brother, father. But here Swami, he has said that, he asked him, his father asked him that, what do you want to say about this incident? Swami said, one of the naughtiest boy he was, and I told you in the beginning itself, unexpected turn, some events, no, it took unexpected turn in his life. So, if he accept his father, if he didn't tell anything to that, no, oh, like that, if he had accepted that, no, nothing would be happened to in his life. But he didn't expect, no, accepted that. He said, I think he must have been a very strong and grown up person, not a boy at all. And he said that no more is a boy, he must be a grown up person. Because small boys, they cannot fight the tiger, no, they are having certain fear to fight with the tiger. So he said that he must be a grown up person. Like that he said. How could a boy fight a tiger? So he was a small boy, how he could fight a tiger? So that he thinks that is must be not a boy, he must be a grown-up person. Then his father replied that, you think you are wiser than the newspaper? Wiser, wise. Wise means those who are having knowledge. So knowledge is called as wise. So his father said that, you think you are wiser than the newspaper? Nino, newspaper gintanu buddhivantana nino. Aa kelthare. A man may have the strength of an elephant and yet be a coward. So then he is comparing these things. Strongest and he said that grown up and strong kid he talk no. So to that he is responding, a man may have the strength of an elephant. So we all have seen elephant. The elephant is having so much of strength. A man, think that a man is so plumpy, he is looking like an elephant, yet be a coward. So he is looking, he is having the strength. But if he is a coward, coward means not having brave. Dhairya illade iruduna coward anta karithari. Brave opposite, it's our opposite of brave. Brave, coward. Whereas another may have the strength of a straw. Straw means just a stick. Tengin maradu gari baruthe nodi, that is called as straw. It's a straw of coconut. So some another may have the strength of a straw, but he has courage. So those are looking so, then if they have courage, no, he can do anything. ನೋಡೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಸಣ್ಣ ಇದ್ರು ಕೂಡ ಏನ್ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೂ ಮಾಡುವಂತ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಧೈರ್ಯ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಯೋ ದ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಯೋರ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಫಾದರ್, ಈ ಸೇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್, ದ ಕರೇಜ್, ಆ ಧೈರ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಏನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಈ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. ಕರೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್, ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಏಜ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಸೊ ಯೋರ್ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಫಾದರ್, ಕರೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಅ ಎಲಿಫೆಂಟ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಕರೇಜ್, ಯು ಕಾಂಟ್ ಡೂ ಎನಿಥಿಂಗ್. So if you are so thin, if you are so lean, if you have courage, you can do anything. Then Swami is not ready to accept his father whatever he is telling. So he disputed the theory. How can it be, father? Suppose I have all the courage, what could I do if a tiger should attack me? And he is comparing that with him. Says father, okay, I am having courage. If a tiger come in front of me, how could I fight with the tiger, father? Then his father said him, leave alone strength. Can you prove you have courage? Okay, leave the strength. So whatever the strength you have now, you leave that. Will you prove me that do you have courage? Let me see if you can sleep alone tonight in my office room. Now his father told him to show his courage. So he is telling that he is not having strength now. That boy, no, he must have a grown-up person. And here his father is telling that to prove his courage. So strength, leave that strength. Okay, you are not having strength, you are a small boy, no? At least will you prove that you have courage? A frightful proposition, Swami thought. Oh, he thought that something wrong is going on in his life. He had always lived beside his granny in the passage, and any change in his arrangement kept him trembling and awake all night. So he had one habit. Daily he used to sleep beside his granny. Every day he used to sleep beside his granny. If there is any changes in that if it is happening, it's troubling him and awake all night. He couldn't sleep throughout the night if he did not sleep beside his granny. He hoped at first that father was only joking. So in the beginning he thought that just simply his father is telling that he was joking, will happen and he will not force me to sleep alone and anywhere. He mumbled weakly and he went to his father and he was requesting. Mumble means requesting. He is requesting his father that weakly, yes, and try to change the subject. Okay, his father, can you prove your courage? Yes, no. In a weak voice he said that, okay, yes. So that is also not okay, I'll sleep, father. He did not told like that. He said that in a weak voice, yes, father. And now he wanted to change the topic. He wanted to divert his father's mind so that he started to tell many other things to his father. He said very loudly and with great deal of enthusiasm. So he thought that his father will leave that matter there itself. And he said that we are going to admit even elders in our cricket club hereafter. Swami and his friend usually used to play the cricket. And here he is telling that even we are going to admit elders. ದೊಡ್ಡವ್ರನ್ನ ಕೂಡ ನಮ್ಮ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಟೀಮಿಗೆ ಸೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಅನ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ. ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ಈ ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ಟಾಪಿಕ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಲ್ಸ್. ಅವರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ ಯು ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಈವನ್ ಇನ್ ನಮ್ಮ ಕ್ರಿಕೆಟ್ ಕ್ಲಬ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಬೈಯಿಂಗ್ ನ್ಯೂ ಬ್ರ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಬ್ಯಾಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಬಾಲ್ಸ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ ಟೀಮ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪ್ಟನ್ ಈ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ಮೀ ಟು ಆಸ್ಕ್ ಯು ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈ ಕುಡ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. We will see about that later. But his father was very stubborn. Whatever the topic he said that we will see that later. Father cut in, you must sleep alone hereafter. And then he ordered him that you should sleep alone hereafter. ಇದಾದ್ಮೇಲಿಂದ ಇನ್ಮೇಲಿಂದ ನೀನು ಒಬ್ಬನೇ ಮಲಗಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಮೀ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಆಡ್ ಗೋನ್ ಬಿಯಾಂಡ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್. ದೆನ್ ಹಿ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎಸ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್. ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ ಬಿಗಿನಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್. ಸೊ ಇಸ್ ಫಾದರ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಯು ಶೋ ಯುವರ್ ಕರೇಜ್. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಅ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್. ನಿನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಇರೋ ನಿನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ನಿನ್ನ ಹತ್ರ ಧೈರ್ಯ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಶೋ ಮಾಡ್ತೀಯ ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರು. ನೌ ದಟ್ ಚಾಲೆಂಜ್ ಈಸ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಕಮಾಂಡ್. Command means they have to obey. Here, Swami should sleep alone here. He knew his father's tenacity at such moments. So he knew that his father's tenacity, that means his determination. His father, he won't change his mind that he come to know. From the first of next month, I will sleep alone, father. So these all are, he wanted to change his father's mind. And he said that in the beginning, he said that we are going to take elders to our cricket team. And now he is telling that he want to escape from that. And now he is telling that from next month, I'll sleep alone, father. No, you must do it now. It is disgraceful sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby. No, no, no. From today itself, you should do this. Sleeping beside granny or mother like a baby is disgraceful according to Swami father, Swami's father. You are in the second form and I don't like the way you are being brought up. He said and looked at his wife. And he said that you are in the second form. Second form means it's a seventh standard. So seventh standard means a grown up child. Okay? That child can sleep alone, I think so. And while telling this, he looked at his wife. Then his wife, she became very angry. In that time, she was rocking the cradle. Swami had a small brother and that baby was very small. She was rocking the cradle while in that time she said, she asked him that, why do you look at me when you say it? She asked, why you are looking at me and why you are telling like that? I hardly know anything about the boy. She don't know anything more about that boy. Granny of Swami, no, she knew a lot of things about Swami, but Swami's mother, she don't know more about the boy. No, no, I don't mean you, said father. Then father said that, no, 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 I don't mean you. You are not spoiling the baby like that, Easter. If you mean your mother is spoiling him, tell her so and don't look at me, she said and turned away. So if you are thinking your mother is spoiling, that granny is spoiling that baby, no, go and tell your mother why you are looking at me like that. She become very angry and she turned towards that side. So that's it for today's class, children. And here some questions are there. So go through the questions, try to answer that in the next